الدليل الثالث,
the third proof,
يقول الله تبارك وتعالى في سورة النساء, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم, آية الإجماع, وهي دليل على الإجماع, يستدل بها علماء الأصول على الإجماع. اذكروا من يشاقق الرسول من بعد ما تبين له الهدى ويتبع غير سبيل المؤمنين نوله ما تولى ونصله جهنم وساءت مصيرا.
The Sheikh mentioned another ayah, the third ayah in Surah An-Nisa. And the ulama, they mention it, that there is ijma' upon it. The ulama, the consensus. And that ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَنْ يُشَاقِقَ الرَّسُولِ, and whoever opposes the messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, after guidance has been made clear to that person, and he chooses to be on a path other than the path of the believers, we shall leave him on that path that he has chosen, and we shall cast him in the hellfire, and what a terrifying place to be indeed. Now,
الآن أريد أن أسأل.
He says, now I want to ask,
كيف نستخرج وجه الاستدلال من هذه الآية؟ الآن أعتبركم خبراء, الآن عندكم آيتين, الآن أريد استدلال في الآية الثالثة.
So the Sheikh says, now you're supposed to be expert already because we mentioned two ayahs, the ayah 100 in Surah At-Tawbah, the ayah in Surah Al-Baqarah, now this ayah. So what is, how do you understand, what is the point of reference here, what is the connection of this ayah to the topic we're talking about, the obligation of adhering to the way of the Salaf?
دعني أقرب لكم الاستدلال.
He said, let me make it easier for you, inshallah.
الآية التي معنا نحن نستدل بها على وجوب اتباع الصحابة.
He said, this ayah, we are using it as a proof that is an obligation to adhere to the way of the Sahaba, the companions of the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم.
كيف نستخرج وجوب اتباع الصحابة في هذه الآية مع أنه لم يذكر صحابة؟
So the Sahaba are not mentioned in this ayah. The Sahaba are not mentioned. So how we understand from it that it is Allah that is obligatory upon us to adhere to their way? نعم.
نحتاج إلى فقيه.
نعم.
أحسنت. نعم. صحيح.
نعم. Brother Nasir حفظه تعالى, he says, because Allah says, and if a person choose a path other than that of the believers, he says, and the believers at that time when this ayah was revealed, they were the companions.
لم يكن أصلا يعني مصدقون ومؤمنون إلا الصحابة في ذلك الوقت.
Because at that time it was nobody else that believed in the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, and they were believers and they accept with truthfulness that what he mentioned except the companions.
والآية أيضا عامة يعني تصلح لما بعد عصر الصحابة, لكن الصحابة يدخلون فيها دخولا أوليا.
He said, even though yes, the ayah is about the companions, they are the believers, but it includes also anyone who come after them and hold on firm to what they were upon amongst the believers. نعم.
عندنا في الآية أيضا الله سبحانه وتعالى بمفهوم الموافقة عرفنا أن اتباع وجوب اتباع الصحابة من قوله سبيل المؤمنين.
He says, now in this ayah, once again, we understood that it is obligatory to adhere to the way of the companions, this is Salaf al-Saleh, because the ayah says, and the one who choose to be on the path other than the way of the believers. Okay, the believers here is the companions in the first place.
من يستخرج لنا مفهوم المخالفة؟
So now who will give us the opposite meaning in this ayah?
Only one.
Hassan.
تشرح زيادة يعني. صحيح أن اتباع غير سبيل المؤمنين محرم, لكن أين مفهوم المخالفة؟ هذا الذي ذكرته هو الآية, لكن مفهوم المخالفة العكس. صحيح.
نعم.
نعم. وينجو من النار الذي في آخر العذاب في آخر الآية.
نعم, that's exactly the answer. Because now the ayah is talking about those who do not follow what the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم came with, and they oppose the way of the believers, they will be casted in the hellfire. Yeah. So the opposite meaning, if they adhere to what the companions are upon, they will be saved from the hellfire.
نعم. ويدخلون الجنة.
And they will enter الجنة.
نعم. لا يكفي. طيب.